Just gotta go for it. It's like Barton Springs.
It's kind of got that milky blue, like the glacier lakes.
Oh yeah, this is glacier fed for sure.
Chips, salsa, and guac. Breakfast of champions.
Good morning, y'all. Today we're gonna take you on our favorite quarantine adventure.
We've been in Austin for about 10 weeks now, and one of the things that's kept us sane throughout this time is being able to get out and go for runs and walks throughout the neighborhood.
So my parents' neighborhood has tons of resident-only trails, and they're absolutely beautiful, and since they're private and they're not open to the public, they aren't very busy, so we're able to safely explore without worrying about running into a ton of people.
Or trees. So today we're gonna explore some of these trails and enjoy some of our favorite Texas snacks along the way.
So the first trail we're gonna do today is gonna take us to this beautiful little overlook of Lake Austin.
And if you follow us on Instagram, which if you don't, you should, you might have got a sneak peek of this trail that we did a couple weeks ago for Mother's Day.
So before Mother's Day, just a couple weeks ago, we had no idea that a trail with this view was in the neighborhood.
Found a bunny.
Wow.
We always see these on our morning runs. They're cute as a button.
I made it! Very, very small overlook, but look at this view!
We got up early to beat the heat. It's been so hot and muggy and just sticky outside. Like when we go on our morning runs, it's just not comfortable. So to beat the heat, we brought some cold brew. Some cold brewskis? No, cold brewskis.
Cold brew skis.
Cold brewskis, yeah, something like that.
So our first Texas snack we wanted to share is Cuvée Cold Brew. So Cuvée is a local roaster here in Austin. They have a shop on East Austin. So if you're ever visiting, go check it out. It's a really cool space. But they sell these little canned nitro black coffee cold brews. So there's like the foam in there like you'd get if you got a nitro cold brew at an actual coffee shop. And it is so good. Cause we're so hot. We're so sticky and hot. And the sun's not even out. Yeah, it's only 8 something. That was a mustache?
No. Dang it. Good try though. There it is.
So next we're gonna head to this pond that I just randomly saw on Google Maps one day, and then I found that there's a trail that can get you to it, and then I saw a YouTube video with drone shots from, or like looking over the pond, and it looks so cool, so we're gonna go try to find it.
It's getting hot. It was warm to begin with. Now it's just getting, it's gonna be scalding here soon.
Yeah, we're very thankful that we have these trails, and my parents live in a beautiful part of Austin, so it hasn't been that bad being stuck here.
Yeah.
But man, this heat, we are very excited to go north. Yeah. Where, like, the highs are in the 70s. Yeah. So we're right here, and the pond is right here. So I'm thinking this little trail will take us there.
Just over the bank here, huh?
Yeah, we'll see. We found it! Cool. It's a little
murky looking.
Has a little bit of weird stuff on the top, but that's okay.
Yeah.
Have it all to ourselves.
Yeah, this stuff's like orange on the...
Yeah, I don't know what that is. It's kind of gross looking, but pretend it's flowers. So we want to have a little picnic. We're gonna try to get over there. I think there's a trail that'll take us.
Oh yeah, cool. This would be a cool spot.
Cool. Sweet. It's kind of got that milky blue, like the glacier lakes.
Oh yeah, this is glacier fed for sure. So for our little Texas picnic, we're of course going with chips, salsa, and guac. Breakfast of champions. It's still 10:40. Well, it's not breakfast time anymore.
We haven't eaten yet though.
It's brunch, so we got Mark's Good Stuff salsa. This is no lie, it's the good stuff. And then we're gonna dip the Julio's chips in there. And these are awesome because they have their own like special seasoning on them. They're so good. They're especially good with the salsa too, but we really like that salsa, so we went with that.
We also got this homemade guac from HEB, and if any of you are familiar with Texas, HEB is our big chain of grocery stores here, and it is the best grocery store in the world, and we can say that because we've been all over the US now. We've been to many grocery store chains, and this is one of our favorites. So guac's kind of not really like a Texas thing per se, but we eat it a lot here in Texas, and we got the spicy flavor because we like it spicy.
When we get salsa, we normally like to get fresh salsa, but when we do go with the jarred one, we always try to find this one. Sometimes you can find it throughout the US, but when we're in Texas, we especially get it. Been waiting all morning for this. So good. Got vinegar in it, so it's a little tangy. And we got the roasted one, so you can taste like the roasted tomatoes, peppery, salty, a little bit sweet, tangy. So good, especially with these chips. I like these chips by themselves too.
I don't know if I've said this on the vlog before, but I don't like onions, especially raw onions. So this one's nice because it does have some chunks of onions, but you can easily pick around them. And it's kind of a mix of chunky and more creamy guac. It's gonna go really well with these chips, which by the way, these chips have like paprika, garlic, some other spices, good old MSG. They're great. It's just so creamy and fresh tasting. It tastes just like you made it yourself, except we didn't have to, we just bought it. So we kind of cheated, but it is dang good. And it has a little bit of a kick, a little bit of spice in there, but it's not too spicy at all.
Another crazy awesome thing is we've seen maybe 5 people all this morning.
It's been amazing.
I don't know if it's the heat or what, but
it's Memorial Day weekend too, so you'd think people would be out, but they're probably out on their boats on the lake, but we don't have a boat.
Our last hike for the day is actually right behind Catherine's house. Pretty cool and convenient. And last time we were there, there was like a pool with like a waterfall
slide thing.
Yeah, it's almost like a slide, like a rock slide. And if it's full enough with water today, I might slide down. Alright, we made it.
We did it!
Alright, here's the slide right here. I want to do it, but I'm kind of nervous at the same time. I don't want to bust my tailbone.
Cold?
A little chilly. All these water bugs, kind of gross, but... Oh. Gotta go for it. It's like Barton Springs. Oh.
I'm gonna go in, but I have pants on, so I'm gonna be very wet the rest of the day.
Pretty chilly, huh?
It's cold, but
it's not horrible.
This feels so nice. My pants are absolutely soaked, but it was worth it. It felt so good.
Our next Texas snack are these pork and beef smoked sausages. They're kind of like beef jerky, which is kind of a, I think it's kind of a Texas thing. And these are Mike's recipe apparently, but they're sold by HEB.
And we promise this video is not sponsored by HEB. We wish, just love HEB.
We wish it was, and if they're listening, we're ready to sign on the dotted line. If you want to keep us stocked up with chips and salsa, we're ready.
Yeah, but I mean, HEB just makes such great stuff. Oh, and when yeah. we're in Texas, we just love going HEB.
For sure.
So I think these, you know, jerky and meat in general is kind of a big
For
Texas
sure.
thing. So we're going to consider this a Texas snack. It's a very wrinkly sausage. I've never actually had one of these.
Yeah?
Adam loves them though.
They're super good. I found them at HEB like probably a year ago, maybe.
It's like a high quality Slim Jim.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nice smoky flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Beefy, porky. Excellent. Just a fun little snack.
Easy to hike and walk with them.
Mm-hmm.
So some of you watching might not be from Texas and you might be wondering, well cool, these snacks look great, but how can I try them? But I think HEB ships nationwide. I'll double check, and if this clip is in the vlog, that means they do. But that way you can try these snacks in whatever state you live in. According to my phone, we did 21,633 steps and 8.8 miles.
Nice. And we have one more Texas snack, and it's gonna be well deserved.
But it's in my parents' house. Yeah. This is my parents' dog, Maui. She's the sweetest girl. And if you know, our dog's name is Kona. So we got two Hawaiian ladies.
For our final Texas snack, we have delicious, delectable Bluebell ice cream, which in our Austin Takeout Edition.
Our last vlog.
Yeah, we had a shake from Mighty Fine and they use Bluebell. It's just vanilla, but we got one of our favorite flavors, butter pecan.
So Bluebell is a Texas staple when it comes to ice cream. They do sell it now in other states. I think a lot of the southern states, we've had it in New Mexico and stuff, but it's from Brenham, Texas, which is about an hour and a half from Austin. They have a factory that you can tour there, which we've done, and it was really fun.
So much fun. They give you a little cap.
Yeah, it's really fun. And you get samples, so that's the best. But we got the butter pecan flavor for a couple of reasons. One, we love it. And two, the state tree of Texas is a pecan tree. So we thought this would be a double Texas whammy for our final snack. But it is melting because it is very hot.
Yeah.
Mmm. It is so creamy. It got little like chunks of pecan and the crunch.
It's perfect on a hot summer day.
And there's seriously no better way to reward yourself for a hike than ice cream. We hope you guys enjoyed our little quarantine hike around my parents' neighborhood. My family's lived here for about 20 years now, and we definitely had no idea how much beauty was literally in our backyard when we lived here full-time in Austin. So one positive thing about being in quarantine is being able to explore all these trails and have just so much beauty to see, even though we've been, you know, stuck in one place for a long time.
But now it's time for us to down this pint of ice cream. Don't judge us. I go left.
Oh god, what was that?
What?
Oh, it was my. Oh my god, this just touched my arm. I was like, what is touching me? Oh, it scared me so bad because I looked and there was no plant. I'm like, what on earth?
It's a snake.
Well, it has like a rubbery feeling, so it felt like a human or something. Trying to get rid of all the spider webs. This just scared the crap out of me, but he did.
He met his last day.
He's got them quarantine curls.
I'm so ready for a haircut, you guys. I have the appointment set. I'm so ready. I feel like I'm wearing a beanie right now. It's so hot.
Farmer's tan.
Check that out. Sick, huh? Look at that. The neckline?
Yeah. Now he wants some Bluebell too. Oh, hi.
Not for doggies.
Not for you. Sit.